Welcome to the first lecture of a new unit, that is fuels. I am Mr. Abhijit Gurav. This is a picture of fossil fuels and this is a renewable energy source. Fuels, as you know, any compound or substance which when burned, which produces heat or energy, is called as fuel. If you consider 1 kg wood and 1 kg simple papers, if you burn both, you will get more amount of energy from wood because it is a substance which on complete combustion produces heat or energy. That's why wood is called as a fuel. So what we are going to learn in this unit, that is classification of fuels, calorific value. There are two types of calorific value, that is gross calorific value and net calorific value. Then analysis of fuels, in which we are going to see analysis of solid fuels, which includes ultimate analysis and proximate analysis. Let us see one by one. Classification of fuels. Fuels are classified on the basis of their physical state, means whether they are solid, liquid or gases. According to that, there are three types of fuels. If you see the pictures, here is an example of coal and wood. These are the solid fuels. Then petrol, diesel, kerosene, these are the liquid fuels. Also naphtha, LPG, that is liquefied petroleum gas, it is a type of gaseous fuels. Also there may be LPG, CNG, LNG, biogas, etc. are the examples of gaseous fuels. Now this is the question for you. Define fuel. Give the classification of fuel. Now calorific value. When a fuel is burned, there is some energy that can be produced by combustion of fuel. So whatever the amount of energy that is liberated by complete combustion of unit quantity of fuel, you have to consider the unit quantity. Suppose that may be 1 milligram, that may be 1 gram, 1 kilogram of fuel is considered, and after complete combustion of that particular fuel, whatever the energy is liberated, that energy is nothing but the calorific value. So this calorific value can be expressed in the kilocalorie per kg or kilojoule per kg. These are the units of calorific value. Then this calorific value are of two types, that is gross calorific value, it is also called as GCV. So this GCV, that is a total amount of heat which is produced when a unit quantity of fuel is burnt, and whatever the products of combustion, that may be the gases, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, or that there may be moisture is also there. So these products of combustion are cooled at room temperature and they collected. So whatever the highest amount of energy you will get is the gross calorific value, and it is higher calorific value. Next one, that is net calorific value. As you see, this net calorific value is also called as NCV. So this is the difference, that main difference. Whatever the product of combustions are there, they are allowed to escape. But in gross calorific value, we are collecting the products and cooling that products at the room temperature. So this is the main difference in between the NCV and GCV. That's why this net calorific value is lower calorific value as compared to GCV. Analysis of solid fuels. In solid fuels, we are going to see example of coal. So there are different types of coal according to their quality, according to their percentage of carbon, and according to the amount of energy or calorific value that can be liberated by the fuels. So analysis is very important for the solid fuels and particularly for the coal. So there are two types of analysis. One is proximate analysis. So what is this proximate analysis? This includes the analysis of percentage moisture, percentage ash, and percentage volatile matter. Also, this proximate analysis includes the percentage of fixed carbon which is present in a coal. That's why this proximate analysis is approximately done analysis. That's why it gives a fair idea about the quality of coal. Next one, that is ultimate analysis. So ultimate analysis, it is the higher step of analysis than as compared to the proximate analysis. It includes the analysis of carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, and sulfur. These are the different gases. When they burn, they can be converted into their oxides, and hence the analysis can be done accordingly. So this ultimate analysis is useful for calculating the heat balances for any process for which coal is used as a fuel, and it is also known as elemental analysis. So whatever the elements, that is carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur, they can be analyzed, which are present in fuel. So these gases or these elements are analyzed. So this is the next question, that is, what is proximate and ultimate analysis, and define calorific value. What are the types of calorific value? So in this lecture, you have learned classification of fuels, calorific value, that is gross calorific value and net calorific value, analysis of fuels, that is ultimate analysis, and proximate analysis. In next lecture, we will see proximate analysis in details. So save fuels, save energy, save planet. Thank you.